let me update you guys. It's been so long. So we've been in our house for about, I want to say about, let me go down because I know somebody's going to be in the comments like, what does your body look like now? And even this is what I'm looking like now. I hope y'all can tell. Still like my shape. I have gained a lot of weight, you guys. On my leg, I don't know if y'all can see that. I had an incident with, it looks like somebody just beat me up. Let me see if I can show you guys. Oh my gosh, do y'all see that? It's all over my arm. I tried to do laser on myself. And if you're dark skinned, I'm going to give you a hint right now. Do not, girl, do not try to do laser. I ordered one of these. Let me show you. One of these electronic laser machines, and it does work, but I thought, you know, it doesn't hurt, so I'm gonna put it like on 9 or 10 and do my whole body, and everything was fine. They say I woke up with scars everywhere, burns everywhere. So now I've been trying to get that off of my body. I've been using cocoa butter, I've been using bio oil. If anybody else knows anything to help remove scarring, let me know. But we've been in our house, I want to say about 4 to 5 months now. Really enjoy it. It's brought me and my fiance so much closer. Still no wedding. We definitely wanted to plan our wedding for next year, but oh yeah, that's another thing. COVID happened. I was gonna flat iron my hair, so I'm gonna be sitting in this stool and I'll talk to you guys. So yeah, let me position my camera. Okay, there we go. So also, you guys, something else that happened. I am wearing a sew-in. It has been so long since I haven't worn a sew-in like since college, y'all. So it's been so long, but I absolutely miss it. I miss how natural it looks. I love this. I know it's not good for your leave out to be flat ironing it every day, and I don't, but just for the sake of the video, and I want it to look decent, I'm gonna spray a little heat protectant and flat iron it while I talk to y'all guys. I'm not gonna do nothing fancy, not going anywhere, still slightly quarantined. Y'all, I get out of breath so easy. It is crazy. But so yeah, I haven't talked to you guys since COVID happened. So as many of you know, or if you don't know, I am a flight attendant. And luckily they gave us some options because, you know, we really didn't know what was going to be happening with travel and everything. They gave us some options to either take a leave for 3, 6, or 9, or 12 months. Or you could stay working if you felt comfortable. I definitely took a leave for 3 months, but then I took a personal leave before they offered that because I didn't know they were going to. So I haven't worked in the last, what, 2, 3 months it's been since the COVID thing happened, because I was, you know, I didn't know what was gonna happen. You know, I was terrified, I was afraid that I would bring something home to my fiance. And at that time, when I was still working, it had just broke out, and I saw the way that they were cleaning the planes, and y'all, it wasn't good, and I just didn't trust it. I know the turnover time that they try to beat to be safe, and even still, I haven't flown, but you know, my flight attendant friends that are still working and still flying, you know, they're supposed to be social distancing people and leaving middle seats open. But a lot of flight attendants are saying that's not happening. Flights are oversold. And I knew it would be that way. It's a lot of stuff that goes on in the airline industry that nobody talks about. Everybody's too scared to talk about. A lot of the times because we still work at these places and they are heavy against, you know, speaking out on social media and what you say. But if you are flying, if you have to fly, I would say only fly if you need to. Definitely make sure you're being safe, you're taking the precautions. Try to go on an early or a late flight times when people may not be flying as much. But they're still overselling flights. People are still flying just leisurely, and it's just not a good thing to do. And I just didn't want to be in that environment with everything going on. I didn't want to have to be fighting passengers over, we're not getting snacks and y'all aren't doing anything and all this other stuff. Because if you've been on a flight, then you know, or if you haven't, let me update you, because I know a lot of people just really don't know what's going on the plane. Because of social distancing, they've been letting the flight attendants, either depending on your airline, hand out little goodie bags in a plastic bag. That's Chai. Let me open the door for her. Come on. No, it's Chai. She's in here now. So they've been giving goodie bags, or they've been not doing a service at all. And I already know people, it's just people are so insensitive, they don't understand. So they're like, I've been seeing my friends say, people are like, we need a snack, we need something to drink, I want a Coke. Like, really? You don't have time to drink a Coke. You need to have your mask on, first of all. I don't know. Just people are so insensitive. And then they blame the airlines, but at the same time, it's like, why are you flying right now unless you like definitely have to go, like a death in the family or something? Why are you flying right now? But yeah, so I was talking about the wedding. I don't know how I got on the airline or what I did, I don't know, but I did want to talk about the wedding. We were planning to plan our wedding for next year. That's still the plan, but a lot of people don't understand, like now with COVID and everything, like basically all the brides that were gonna get married this year can't get married because of COVID. So either they've had two options to do a small like reception type thing with a drive-by audience or something outside, you know, with the drive-by audience, or you can wait until next year and see what happens. And so all the brides from this year basically have been pushed to next year. So now it's really hard to know where you fit in, and nobody wants to do a winter wedding. Everybody's against winter weddings, including me. I really don't want to do a winter wedding, but if I can have my wedding, really, I'm just ready to have it. So trying to get like your bartender, trying to get your DJ, just all on the same accord, your cake, your decorations, everything, trying to get everything on the same accord has been pretty difficult, because people don't know where they stand. They don't know if their brides are going to pick another, you know, date. They don't know. Everybody's kind of in limbo, just trying to see what's going to happen. But, you know, now the laws are loosening up. If y'all didn't know, I live in Texas, specifically Dallas, Texas. And the laws are loosening up, so we will see. Yeah, I'm not going to do that much. Y'all, I'm not going nowhere. I just felt like flat ironing my hair. I'm not gonna do that much to my hair, but can I tell y'all, I missed sew-ins. I just missed it. I know you're not supposed to put heat on your hair every day, and I don't do it every day because I haven't been going anywhere every day, but I just miss having a natural hairline. Like, I just miss that. But I can lay my edges too, I guess. That's it. But yeah, so everybody's in limbo with the wedding thing. So a lot of people don't know when they're gonna get married, what's gonna happen. We still plan to get married very soon, as soon as we can. We began saving. We had a list of things that we wanted to do and accomplishments that we wanted to take care of before the wedding. One was our home, and I absolutely love our home. I love the area we stay in. I love everything about it. The other one was I wanted to get a new car, which if you follow me on social media, then you already know that I got a new car, which was definitely a blessing, y'all. I manifested this car. I remember, oh gosh, it was about maybe 3 years ago, my friend asked me, we were talking about cars or something, dream cars. I don't know what we were talking about. We were at a friend's wedding, And I said, I wanted a Mercedes. I'm gonna get me a Mercedes. I always told everybody that I didn't know how I was gonna get a Mercedes. Definitely wasn't making enough money to get a Mercedes at that time, but I knew it was gonna happen. I just didn't let it go. Like, I spoke it to it into existence. And of course, it wasn't an overnight success. I know many people think because of the Instagram era, everything just happened and you're so blessed and lucky. Blessed, yes, but definitely it wasn't just given. I got this car all on my own, paid for it on my own, and I waited until I was ready. I had my previous car, my Mustang. I had it for, let's say, that car is a 2012. So yeah, I've been riding that car. I keep my cars pretty good. Like, I've only had one other car besides that, and I kept that for a long time. So I'm not very rough on my cars, but yeah. I got a new car, which I'm so happy about, and now we got the house. Now we're just gonna save up and make sure we have our wedding next year. And if push comes to shove and we have to do a smaller little ceremony, then so be it. But it's my dream to absolutely have, you know, a nice wedding. Not big. I think we already did like a guest list, so it's only gonna be about maybe 100 people. Maybe, if that. Maybe it'll only be like 80, I don't know. But a lot of the people are Enrique's line brothers. I really don't have that many friends. That's another story for a different day. As I've gotten older, I just have minimized my friendship circle. And not in a negative way. Like, I feel really happy where I am and the people that I have in my life. But I feel like I finally let people go. I didn't know where they were standing in my life, or they were not a positive influence, and I just kind of, you know, just let them go, which is something you have to do. Sorry, my camera cut off, guys. But we were talking about friendships, and I was saying that's something you have to do as you get older. And a lot of people that watch me, you're probably like, maybe in my age range, but a lot of people that watch me from what I've seen are like in their 20s. So you have time to figure it out. And you may still be friends with your friends forever, but people change and you grow and you have different mindsets and you just separate. And it's not, for me, it hasn't been like a negative situation. It's just been, we've grown apart and we're just in different places in life right now. And maybe one day we'll reconnect, but right now we're just not on the same wavelength. So go your own way, and I wish you the best. No harm, no foul. Like, I don't wish anybody that I've disconnected with any, you know, ill intentions. I've just had to separate myself from that energy. So, yeah. So since y'all haven't seen in a while, I will take y'all on a quick tour of the house. I know y'all probably want to see, since it has been, the last time y'all saw the house, it was completely empty. Of course, I have some stuff, but since of COVID and everything, I haven't really fully decorated. The downstairs is my biggest project. It's giving me the biggest headache. It's been the hardest to figure out, so yeah. But let me take y'all to my closet, because it's right here, and show y'all how that looks. So give me 1 second, I'm just wrapping up my pattern. Okay, so this is the closet. Last time y'all saw it, it was completely empty. Let me turn on the light so you can, y'all guys can see. So of course I told y'all I would fill it up. I did become nice and give Enrique a little section right here, but this is the closet. Absolutely love it. And yeah, we filled up all our stuff on there. And I got a mirror right here. You can see the scars on my legs now, like really bad, y'all. I can't believe I did that. Look at that. And it's on my arm too. So if you're thinking about doing the laser on yourself, do not. I just bought this yoga mat because
They are going to do a online yoga class for black girls. I think it's called Black Girl Yoga. I'm following them on Instagram if you want to check them out. I need a way to kind of release from everything that's been going on. You can see my body a little bit better. I mean, like I said, it was nothing outrageous, just something very natural. I got all my shoes up here, and then my little purse closet right here. And that's that. And then you walk into the bathroom, which is where I was when we first started. That is the toilet area. It's a walk-in shower, and then the bath. I got this on Amazon. I absolutely love it. And then our room. So you guys have not seen our room. Wow, the color really changed. So this is our room and our bed set. I decided to do gray. It looks really crazy right now. Just ignore that. I was not planning to film at all, but I just wanted to be real and show y'all what's going on. So we have this little bench right here. Chai's bed, her steps when we laid her on the bed, and the TV and the dresser with some books over here. So yeah, upstairs is still not done. That's Enrique's man cave, and so it's still, I'm sorry, I'm doing laundry as well. Fun stuff, huh? Babe. Okay, so I will make sure I change this laundry out in a minute. This is the laundry room. I guess I can show you guys that too. I'm just gonna turn it off because it makes noise, and yeah. Chai's clothes are in here. And yeah, all of my little cleaning supplies. So my favorite room is my beauty room. I finally finished my beauty room, except one thing is supposed to come like next week. That's the chair for this desk. So this is my room. I was heavily inspired by another YouTuber, a black YouTuber named Kyra. She had some great ideas that I took, but I kind of made it my own. For one, it was definitely this wallpaper and these photos of black women who I absolutely admire. Diana Ross, you know, like Eartha Kitt, everything, you know, just black women looking glamorous. I feel like a lot of times we don't have these portraits. I couldn't even find these portraits in stores. I had to actually find them online, and then I sent them to a website called Mixed House, which makes these little borders right here, and you can stick them to the wall and you can take it off and you can stick it again, which is amazing. I absolutely love them. This was something I bought because I was going to do my engagement photo shoot before COVID happened. But how cute are these? All my makeup, setting sprays, hair clips, perfumes. Absolutely love this mirror. I got this on Amazon as well. I love this one because it has an outlet so you can plug in your charger, but you can also use Bluetooth and listen to the radio while you do your makeup. And this is the wallpaper I absolutely love. I feel like it really made the room. I have my vanity over here, which I got this, I don't even remember where I got this from, to be honest, you guys. And so yeah, I absolutely love this. All this stuff that I have, you know, for wedding and engagement, I haven't been buying stuff, guys. It's just, can't really do anything right now. And so my little bookshelf, I have a mirror, my camera's down below, some of my favorite books, and yeah, it's just makeup below there. And the light that my fiance bought me for Christmas. So yeah, that's the room. This Chanel bag actually has a purse in it. I want to do a video. If y'all are interested, please leave it in the comment box below. It's a review on a imitation bag. So I know y'all really liked my last video like that. And yeah, see, I've been trying to get it together. Okay, and when you come over here, this is actually the guest bathroom, and we basically just use the same stuff that was in our last apartment in the house now for the guest bathroom, because I still liked this stuff. It wasn't nothing wrong with this stuff. So this is how I decorate it. Very simple. And right here is actually the guest room. We are still going to get the TV on this wall so the guests can have something to watch, but we haven't had any guests because of COVID or anything. But this is the guest room, and yeah, it's a nice size. And then let me take y'all to my headache. Of course, I still want to get something for right up here to decorate. So this is the headache. You can already see it's like in shambles. Okay, so guys, this has been the biggest headache of all, because it's been a headache. I don't know how else to explain it. So these two lamps I got at Ross when they were having a sale, they're, I believe you say it, I absolutely love this designer. Every time I see her stuff online, is it Safavia? I don't know. But every time I see it on Wayfair or on House or Overstock, I absolutely always fall in love. And these were like super on sale. They were only $16.99 each. I don't know if y'all can see that, but I plan to do the whole house. We still have this old couch, but this is actually going into Enrique's man cave. So ignore the couch, but the whole aesthetic for this house was less glam, just a little hint of glam, and more of the black, white, gold, silver. So we just ordered a couch and it's gray. It's a sectional that will wrap around. I will do black, gold, and silver pillows on that. If y'all have any ideas, let me know. So these I just bought and Enrique set them up actually today, but I don't know if I like them. They look so small, and I'm thinking maybe we should put them out on the balcony on the third floor, because I'm not, like, something's not going. I don't know. What do y'all think I need to add? I don't know, but I know that table in the middle will be black for sure. And the kitchen, which pretty much looks the same. I added like some magnets of us from Shutterfly. They do magnets, so if you like magnets for your refrigerator, I have a bunch of them on this side, but I didn't want it to look too tacky. So this is a refrigerator in the kitchen, everything like that. And then for this, it's been a headache too. I don't know what I'm gonna do. This is definitely not staying, but this is the bathroom downstairs for the guest when we don't want them to go upstairs, and it's just blah right now. I don't know what to do with it either, guys, but I did want to show you something. My car. Yeah, I'm so proud of myself. I did this all on my own. This is my new car. Turn on the light. See if it'll focus. Focus. I don't know. The humidity or something is not letting it focus, but this is my new baby, y'all. This is my new car. Absolutely love this car. This is her. White interior, so pretty, right? She's brand new, brand spanking new, and I didn't lease, I bought. Because so if there's something that you want, speak it into existence and get it. You deserve it. It has a sunroof on top. I absolutely love this car. It's a Mercedes. I want to tell y'all right. Mercedes A220. So yeah, that's my new car. And yeah, that's really all that's been happening. I want to show you guys also the outside areas. So let me take you guys up there. So guys, this is the balcony area on the third floor. So I decided to go with a black and white theme. This chair is over here. We're gonna get a barbecue pit. Actually, Enrique is putting up the other curtains. They'll be black and white. But yeah, I absolutely love the vibe of it. It has a fan up here, and with the chairs and the curtains, everything is coming along perfectly. But yeah, guys, that's pretty much it. I just wanted to update y'all on what's been going on. I really don't have much to vlog because we've been inside the whole time. But I do have some videos that you guys will be seeing coming forward. I'm just waiting for the right time to actually film and everything. And excuse my face because of the mask. I haven't been breaking out all around here. It's just a lot of stuff has been going on, y'all. It's been really crazy this last couple of months. But even through this craziness, I feel really blessed and like stuff is finally starting to happen to me. Everything that I've wanted and prayed for, it's happening now, despite the other bad things that are happening out on the outside world. In my life has been really good, and I'm incredibly thankful for that. I don't know why I'm always out of breath when I get on here, but sorry guys. I've been incredibly thankful for that, and I feel blessed, and I don't want this video to be insensitive and showing you what I have right now, because a lot of people are without jobs. We're basically in a pandemic right now. I just want to say, don't feel like you have something to prove or that you're less than. Your time is coming. I feel like a lot of this is stuff that I've worked on for years. Nothing was overnight for me. It's never really been easy for me. Everything that I have, I had to really, really put restrictions on myself to get it. And I had to really focus, and it came, I can honestly say that the stuff that is in my life right now, it came when it was supposed to. Like, it came when I was able to handle the responsibility of having these things. And just know your time is coming too. And just because somebody has something doesn't mean they're better than you. People have the exact same problems. I'm riding around in Mercedes, but I still have the same issues I had when I was in my Mustang. You know, like, these are things I work hard for, but they don't make me. And I want to make that clear. They never will. But I just feel really blessed. And I hope I'm giving inspiration to other young women. Specifically all women, but specifically for black young women. You can make it. And life doesn't have to be hard and difficult. Manifest the life you want. Manifest the person you want to be. And show up as her. It don't accept any less from men, from your workplace, from your family. A lot of people told me I shouldn't do this, I couldn't do this, I should do this, and I just had to do it my way. And I just want to say to young women, do it your way and live the life you want. And just because it wasn't possible for somebody else does not mean it's not possible for you. You can have whatever you want in this life, whatever you want in this life, as long as you work towards it and you stay consistent. You can have it. But anyways, I don't want to bore y'all with this speech. I just want to kind of be a little distraction for a couple minutes for you guys. And I will be back soon. I won't take such a long break. But I am happy to be vlogging and just to be on YouTube and be in this space again. And I know I don't have any makeup on. It's just me. But I feel like this is the way a lot of us are right now, because we're not going anywhere really. And if you are going somewhere, you're putting a mask on. So why would you put makeup on over your mask? It's just, it's a mess. But anyways, until next time, y'all, stay positive, stay beautiful, stay you. Smooches.